वैदेहि सहितं सुरद्रुमतले हैमे महामण्डपे मध्ये पुष्पकमासने मणिमये वीरासने सुस्थितं अग्रे वाचयति प्रभञ्जनसुते तत्त्वं मुनिभ्यः परम् व्याख्यान्तं भरतादिभिः परिवृतं रामं भजे श्यामलम् वामे भूमिसुता पुरश्च हनुमान् पश्चात् सुमित्रासुतः शत्रुघ्नो भरतश्च पार्श्वदलयोः वायुवादिकोणेषु च सुग्रीवश्च विभीषण भजे श्यामलम् मदन्वये मद्भागधेयः मणिनूपुराट्यः कोदण्डरामः कुलदैवतं मे जानकीकान्तस्मरणम् विद् द ब्लेसिङ्ग्स् आफ् श्रीयःपति भगवान् श्रीरामचन्द्र वि हेड् अ ग्राण्ड् ओपनिङ्ग् आफ् दिस् सत्सङ्ग वित् ए वण्डर्फुल् प्रवचनम् आन् गुरु महिमा as a continuation of this guru mahima we are going to see shrimad ramayanam it's because shrimad ramayanam also starts only with guru lakshana we all listen to a very great shloka of swami desigam siddham sat sampradaye this shloka this verse is a reflection of Maharshi Valmiki's first shloka found in Ramayana tapasvadhyaya niratam tapasvi vadvidam param naradam paripaprache valmikir munipungavam in this verse Maharshi Valmiki is talking about guru shishya lakshanas among different lakshanas of a guru swadhyaya is a prime lakshana swadhyaya means scriptural learning shastra is extremely important no religion could stand without a scripture in the world and no wisdom could continue without a text for it in the world And that's what the researchers tell. We see throughout the world, almost all theories, insights regarding sciences and arts. But in India, that's withstanding. In spite of all invasions, we can go back to our shastra and find out what we were on those days. There were civilizations, for example, Native America or Egyptian civilization, Mayan culture or early Roman civilization, even early Arabian civilization. All those were great, but as the scriptures of those civilizations are almost not available, therefore now we can't find out what they are before some 500 years ago while the British started to invade the whole world everywhere they crushed the various civilizations and that's how taking the insights from the whole world they started to frame this what we call as modern physics and now we know that they are from the whole world the insights the discoveries are from the whole world but it cannot be proven in a very systematic way that these are from various civilizations on the other hand it can be easily explained that what they have taken from India This is only possible because we have shastra, we have scriptures, so we can easily tell what has gone from Nyaya Shastra, what had gone from Vaisheshika Sutra to modern physics, what had gone from our Sankhya or Yoga philosophy to these schools of thoughts of West. This is only possible because of scripture. Therefore, scriptural study is extremely important. Only through scriptural study, our Guru Shishya Parampara continues up to our time. Swadhyaya, this is Swadhyaya. Our Guru, our Acharya, is a master of the scripture about which he talks about. What is the scripture? In this context, Ramayanam. As our Pravachanam is about Ramachandra's Charitram, Ramayanam is our scripture, and that Guru whom we are adoring blesses us with this great discourse of Ramayana. He knows Ramayana very well, not just as a bookworm. Many people are reading Ramayana. Many people are researching Ramayana. Many people get doctoral degrees from Ramayana. All do not become great acharyas. What's the lakshana of acharya? It's not just reading Ramayana. Even computer can read it. We can make a soft copy out of computer. The computer has all 24 verses in it. But computer cannot become an acharya. Computer cannot be called as a guru. Why? Because computer has all those things in the screen. Whenever we want, it shows. Those are all fine. But the one who lives Ramayana alone is an acharya. This is the practical wisdom. It's not just knowing Ramayana, but living Ramayana. Therefore, aside this Swadhyaya, Maharshi Valmiki also uses the word tapas. Tapaswadhyaya niratam. The one who is deeply interested, one who devotes his time to both tapasya and swadhyaya. There are some great souls who are scholars, who are well versed with the scriptures, but they may not have tapasya. There are few other great souls who are great in tapasya, but they may not be scholars. But a guru is great in tapasya as well as swadhyaya. Swadhyaya is self-learning. Swadhyaya is scriptural knowledge, scriptural learning. Tapasya is to be in that scripture. How to be in that scripture? How to be in Ramayana? As a karma shastra, also as a jnana shastra or bhakti shastra. These are the two ways to see Ramayana. Ramayana is a karma shastra. Ramayana is a dharma shastra. The base of Ramayana is the Vedic literature. The base of everything in Sanatana Dharma is Vedic literature. Vedaha akhila dharma moolam. The Veda talks to us about two great concepts. One is dharma. Another one is Brahman. One is karma, another one is jnana. Regarding dharma, we have various prescriptions in the Vedas. Kurvanneva iha karmani, tiji vishe chatakum samaha, evam tui nanyathe tosti na karma lipyate nare. Various injunctions and prohibitions are there, vidhi nisheda vakyas in the Veda, through which we come to know what is dharma. Matrudevo bhava veda manuchacharyonte vasina manushasti satyam vade dharmam chare. Vedas are ordering us to talk only truth, practice dharma. Then matrudevo bhava pitrudevo bhava, honor your father first, honor your mother, then honor your father. Acharya devo bhava, then honor your acharya. Atithi devo bhava, honor your atithi. यान्यनवध्यानि कर्माणि तानि सेवितव्यानि नो इतराणि. Those deeds which bestow welfare to others alone have to be done. Do not do any other deeds. Do not do harmful deeds. That's how the Vedas are going on talking about various dharmas. But when it comes to practice, Matru Devo Bhava, honor your mother. What does it mean? Then we see in Ramayana how Ramachandra is honoring his mother. How Ramachandra is honoring, taking care of his mother. As soon as he comes to the forest, in the bank of river Ganga, the very first day, he feels for his mother. I have come to the forest. Who is going to take care of my mother Kausalya? How she will be in Ayodhya all alone? That's how Ramachandra laments, Matru Devo Bhava. And we see the devotion of Sri Ramachandra to his stepmother too, not only to his own mother. Mother Kaikeyi. While Bharata is taking leave of Rama in Chitrakuta, Rama says to Bharata, Mataram Raksha Kaikeyi, Ma Rosham Kurutam Prati. Oh Bharata, may you take care of our mother Kaikeyi, Kaikeyi Mata. Be not angry with her. Mayache Sitaya Chaive. This is the order of me and your sister-in-law. Shaptosi Raghunandana. Rama's orders to Bharata. This reveals the devotion that Rama has to even his stepmother. Matru Devo Bhava, Pitru Devo Bhava. How Rama is devoted to his father. Sri Ramachandra says to Mother Kaikeyi, Amma, to keep the word of my father, I can even fall in the forest fire. I can even take venom. Bhakshayeyam visham tikshnam madhyeyam api charnave niyuktaha guruna pitra nrupena chai hitena chai. This is because I am committed to my father in several ways. Niyuktaha guru, if he is my guru, I am his disciple. Guruna pitra, if he is my father, I am his son. Pitra, if he is king, I am a citizen. Drupena che hitena, he is my true well-wisher. In all these ways, I am committed to my father. Therefore, I have to keep his word. This is what he says. Only to keep the word of his father, he went to the forest. That too in his prime age of life, he sacrificed the whole of kingdom. He was dwelling in the forest. This is Pitru Devo Bhava. Then Acharya Devo Bhava. Honor your guru. Where he honors his guru? When Ramachandra comes to know that his guru is on the way to his palace, Rama doesn't say, let him come. This is Abhidhamana. Tamagatam Rishim Ramaha Toranniva Sasambhramaha Manayishyansa Manargam Nishchakrama Niveshanat Abhyatyattvaramanasche Ratabhyasam Manishinaha Tatovatarayama Saparigrihya Ratat Swayam. Rama rushes to Maharshi Vasishta and he is assisting Maharshi Vasishta to get down from the chariot. Rama with the great reverence takes Maharshi Vasishta to his own palace and honors Maharshi Vasishta. This Abhigamana we see in Ramayana, Acharya Devo Bhava, Satyam Vada, be truthful. Be truthful. Veda says, what is to be truthful? Sri Ramachandra, just for a pratigya, I don't know how to translate this pratigya in English, can be called as a swearing or woe or all these words are their Brahmis. Nothing matches with the original word, Sanskrit word, pratigya. Anyhow, let us use the word, the same word, pratigya. Just for a pratigya, for which nobody was a witness except the king Dasharatha and mother Kaikeyi, Rama gave the whole of kingdom and went to the forest. All people are requesting him to come back. His mother is crying, his brothers are crying, his friend Guha is crying, his servant attendant Sumantra is crying. Even though Rama feels their love, he consoles all of them, but not comes back. That's a very interesting thing. Rama's principle is not a principle of convenience. To him, Satyam, truth, is the most important thing. Well, Bharata comes and requests Rama to accept the kingdom. Rama says to Bharata, Satyameva Ishwaraha Loke Satyam Padmashrita Sada Satyamulani Sarvani Satyan Nasti Parampadam. Satyameva Ishwaraha Loke, truth is God. And in truth, Mahalakshmi always dwells. Satyam Padmashrita Sada. All Punya Karyas are rooted in truth. Satyamulani Sarvani. There is nothing greater than truth. Satya Nasti Parampata. Above this, Sri Ramachandra says, Lakshmi Chandra Dabeyatva Himavanva Himam Tyajet Atiyat Sagaro Vedam Pratigyamaham Pituhu. Lakshmi Chandra Dabeyatva, even Lashar can be separated from the moon. Even the snow may, even Himalayas may, even the ocean can cross its border, tsunami may happen. But this Rama will not give up the truth. Satyam vade. Practice dharma. Dharmam chare. What is dharmam chare? We can see Rama's whole life, how it becomes the embodiment of dharma. Rama is dharma embodied, Rama vigrahavan dharma. All his deeds are either attuned to abhyudaya or to nisrayasa. These two are dharma. Yataha abhyudaya nisrayasa siddhihi sa dharma. Abhyudaya means social welfare. Nisrayasa means spiritual welfare. The method, that from which social upliftment and spiritual welfare can be accomplished is dharma. These are different beings. We learn from Rama. In the Vedas, we learn dharma only through indication or injunction and prohibition. But regarding Ramayana, we learn dharma from a human being who practices dharma throughout his life. Rama is dharma embodied. Rama is the Veda embodied. That's the greatness of Ramachandra. So to live Vedic life, Bhagavan, the divine incarnated as Rama in this mortal world, leading a harmonious life, showing way to us, revealing dharma to us, we learn from him. So in this way, when we learn from him in this way, Ramayana becomes a karma, experiencing Rama. Ramayana is a karma shastra when we practice Ramachandra. Ramayana is a bhakti shastra when we enjoy or experience Rama. Both are explained by Brahmadeva, dharmatmanaha gunavataha loke ramasya dhimataha. Ramayana becomes a bhakti shastra because, or jnana shastra because, Ramayana shows Brahman. Brahman, what is Brahman? Brahman has various lakshanas in Upanishads. Yato va imani bhutani jayante yena jatani jivanti. That is one kind of definition for Brahman. Brahman is that from which the whole world is coming, in that whole world is getting sustained. Another definition, Satyam Jnanam Anantam Brahma, all those definitions are there. Brahman is described as attributeless. Brahman is beyond words. Brahman is nameless and formless. That's how Upanishads approach Brahman. Fine. But when the same Brahman is described as Kati Kati Tavalkalam, Ganalasa Jata Mandalam, Karapta Shada Karmukam, the same Brahman is described as a being standing in front of us with the bow and arrow, with the quiver, with the broad chest, broad shoulders, with a smiling face, and in dark complexion as a beautiful cloud. With his benevolent glance, he is gracing us. When Rama is described in this way, when the Brahman is described in this way, it touches our heart. Brahman which is dealt in Upanishads, Brahman which is dealt in Vedanta, it doesn't come to our mind, because that's the definition of Brahman. That which comes to our mind is not Brahman. Yena ahur mano matam. That's how Keno Upanishad says. It's beyond thought, it's beyond mind, it's beyond intelligence. But when the same Brahman incarnates in the mortal world with the form and the name, when the same Brahman is standing in front of us, this Brahman is not different from that Brahman. That's a wonderful understanding. Beautifully, Ramabhadra Dikshitar describes in a metaphorical way, Vedanta Vibhramavane Vihita Pracharaha Kakustavam Samavatirye Kadapi Khelan Valmiki Vannikare Vaguraya Grihitaha Hrutpanjaram Vrajati Kaschidayam Sukho Me Vedanta Vibhramavane Vihita Pracharaha Kaschidayam Sukaha. A beautiful parrot is wandering in the deep woods. Vedanta Vibhramavane, the forest of Vedanta, jungle of Vedanta. In that, a shuka, a parrot is flying. Nobody can touch it. Nobody can catch it. Vedanta Vibhramavane Vihita Pracharaha. No word can touch it. Eto vacho nivartante. No thought can touch it. Aprapya manasasah. That's how this matchless parrot is flying freely. It just comes and sits on a beautiful tree, on a bamboo. Kakusta Vamsham. Vamsha means bamboo. Vamsha also means dynasty. Here Dikshitar makes a pun. Kakusta Vamsham here. Raghuvamsha bamboo. Okay. That parrot comes and gets seated on the bamboo of Raghuvamsha. Hardly it comes like that. Therefore, Kadapi. Kelan, why it came? Just for a sport. Leela. Rabu Kridaya. Even the very word Rama means Leela, Krida. Rama means sporting. He wants to catch that parrot. It will fly. It will fly to another bamboo. Or it will fly to space. Gagana Mandal Par Seji Biyaki. Kiswid Milana Hoi. Mirabhai sings. How to catch this parrot? Ramabhadra Dikshitar found a way to catch this parrot. What's that? He got a net. What's that net? Net prepared by a hunter. Hunter is Valmiki. And a net, what's that net? Net is nothing but Ramayana. వాల్మీకి వాగ్నికర వాగుడయా గృహీతః. He just released that net to catch this parrot. He did not even catch. He just placed in front of the parrot. This net. To recite the shlokas of Ramayana. Gandharva Raja Pratimam Loke Vikyat Paurusham Dirghabhagum Mahasattvam మతమాతంగగామినం చంద్రకాంతాననం రామం అతీవ ప్రియదర్శనం. వెన్ ఐ డూ పారాయణ ఆఫ్ రామకథ, దిస్ ప్యారట్ నేమ్డ్ రామచంద్ర ఎంటర్స్ ఇన్ టు మై హార్ట్. ఇట్ చూసెస్ ఇట్స్ కేజ్. ఐఎమ్ నాట్ క్యాచింగ్ ఇట్. వాట్ ఐ డిడ్ ఈస్ జస్ట్ ఐ హ్యాడ్ this net called Ramayana in my hand, but naturally, effortlessly, the parrot entered into my heart. Hrut panjaram vishati, it chooses its cage because we can't fix a cage for it, but we have to, otherwise it will again fly. If it again flies, it's not easy to catch it. Therefore, I have to fix a fixed cage. What kind of cage? This parrot is beyond value. This parrot is not an ordinary parrot. It's not a trivial one. Therefore, to have this parrot, can I make a cage of gold or silver decked with diamonds? When I am thinking in this way, more than that kind of cage, more value this cage has, the heart. Hrut panjaram vishati, the parrot enters into my heart and it dwells there in my heart. That parrot is none other than Ramachandra. And while it is there in Upanishads, it did not enter into my mind, in my understanding, in my thought. It's always beyond my thought. It's always beyond my thought. Veda Vedye Pare Pumsi Jate Dasaratmaje Vedaha Pracheta Sadasit Sakshat Ramayanatmana. When the Veda, Veda Vedye Pare Pumsi Jate Dasaratmaje, when Bhagavan Narayana, when Brahman came in the form of Ramachandra, the Veda which deals with Brahman, which talks about Brahman, came in the form of Ramayana from the lotus lips of Maharshi Valmiki. Regarding this shloka, Vedavidya Paraipumsi, to explain that shloka, Vedavidya Paraipumsi, Ramabhadra Deekshithar wrote this shloka, Vedanta Vibhramavane. Okay? As a further explanation to this shloka, Vedavidya Paraipumsi, there is a Sri Sri Anna's composition in Ramakathamrita Sara. నిరాకారం తత్వం పరమితి వదన్నేవ నిగమః ఘనశ్యామం చత్వాం నిరవధి గుణం వీక్ష్య సహసా త్రపాం లబ్ధ్వాహంత ప్రథిత చరిత శ్రీ రఘుపతే స్వయం హ్యావిర్భూతః జగతి మధురం వారుణి ముఖాత్ నిరాకారం తత్వం పరం ఇది వదన్. ఉపనిషత్స్ డిస్క్రైబ్ బ్రహ్మన్ యాజ్ నిరాకార పరతత్వ అట్రిబ్యూట్లెస్ ఘనశ్యామం. సడన్లీ ద వేదాస్ సీ ద సేమ్ బ్రహ్మన్ ఇన్ అ బ్యూటిఫుల్ ఫార్మ్ హోల్డింగ్ ద బో. శ్రీ రామచంద్ర, దట్ ఈస్ బ్రహ్మన్, ఈస్ వాండరింగ్ ఇన్ ద ఫారెస్ట్ ఇన్ దిస్ మార్టల్ వర్ల్డ్. దెన్ ద వేదాస్ వండర్ టు డిస్క్రైబ్ దిస్ బ్రహ్మన్ యాజ్ ద అట్రిబ్యూట్లెస్ బ్రహ్మన్ కేమ్ ఇన్ ద ఫార్మ్ ఆఫ్ రామచంద్ర. టు డిస్క్రైబ్ దిస్ బ్రహ్మన్ ఐ ద వేద ఆల్సో హ్యావ్ టు కమ్ ఇన్ ద ఫార్మ్ ఆఫ్ రామాయణ ఆఫ్ ద వేద అండ్ రామాయణ. And here tapasya, what does it mean? It has two meanings. One, practicing Rama in one's own life. If you see Ramayana as Karma Shastra, experiencing Rama, reflecting Rama, enjoying Rama, or recognizing Rama, understanding Rama, knowing Rama, realizing Rama, actualizing Rama, this is tapasya. Therefore, tapasya has these two meanings. Swadhyaya, scriptural learning. Ramayana Parayanam is Swadhyaya. Therefore, Guru should have three main qualities here. One, Swadhyaya, Ramayana Parayanam. Next one, tapasya, which means, on one hand, practicing Ramachandra in one's own life. On the other hand, experiencing and enjoying Rama. Tapas Swadhyaya Niratam. Then the fourth quality of Guru, or fourth qualification of Guru, Vakvidam Varam, his eloquency, Pravachana Samarthyam. He has the divine experience. He also knows the scripture well, but he doesn't know how to present it. It's not like that. He also makes others to know what Rama is. This is Sri Ramakrishna's statement. While Narendra came to Ramakrishna Paramahamsa, he came with a question. Have you seen God? Ramakrishna not only said, I have seen God, but also said, I will make you to see God. Vakvidham varam. This pravachanam, Gurudeva is delivering this pravachanam to us. Through pravachanam, he is communicating God. He makes us to experience the same God which he is experiencing. The same experience he transmits to us, the same knowledge he gives to us, that is Vakvidham varam. Next guna of Guru is, next lakshana of Guru is, Munipungavam. Munipungavam means Mananashila. He is always in the consistent remembrance of that Ramachandra. There is a consistent flow of thought, like Madhudara, like the flow of honey, like the flow of oil. Here in the heart, always Sri Rama is flowing. Rama himself is a Dhara. His name is a dhara, is a flow. His form is also a flow. And above all, his guna, his auspicious virtues, they are also a flow. This flow is always consistently flowing in the heart of a guru. This is Munipungava. Only if that flow consistently comes in the heart of a guru, then only he can deliver the same flow in others also while he is delivering the discourse. If some other gossip, if some other materialistic things flow in his mind, such a kind of filthy things are coming in his mind, at the time of pravachanam also, the time of upanyasam also, the same thing will come. But if he is always in the remembrance of Ramachandra, in pravachanam also, why in pravachanam, if he sits even for a gossip, he cannot gossip. Even there, he will only talk on Rama in the name of gossip. Somebody is coming there to gossip with him. At that time also, that guy who came there, he has forgotten where this person dragged him to Ramayana. You start any topic with him, he will take you to Ramayana. That's such a kind of person he is. And that's a Guru Lakshana. It's why it happens, because always that consistent flow of Rama is there in the heart. The same thing he is doing, Vitarana to others, he is offering to others. is sharing with others, Munipungavam. These are the features of a guru. So five features, I think. Tapasya means anushthana and anubhava. Practice and experience. Swadhyaya, scriptural learning. Then Vagvidambaram, eloquence. Fifth guna or fifth lakshana, Munipungavam, mananashirat, consistent flow of thought regarding consistent feel of Ramachandra. This is the fifth lakshana. These five lakshanas guru has. Then what is Shishya lakshana? Shishya should have more lakshanas than guru, because injunctions are only for Shishyas, not for gurus. Who can give injunctions to gurus? Therefore, we may expect more lakshanas for Shishya than a guru. But here Maharshi Valmiki talks of only one lakshana of a Shishya. What's that lakshana? Tapasvi. Tapasvi is the only lakshana. What is this tapasvi? This tapasvi is nothing but the prapatti. Etatvavah kalu tapayityahuhu yasvam dadatiti. The one who submits himself, this submission is called as tapasya. The submission itself is called as tapasya. This is a kind of nishta, this is a kind of sharanagati, submission. In this way, a disciple submits himself to that guru. Generally, a school is something different from Veda Patashala. In a school, what is expected is intelligence. Is he intelligent? Are his parents educated? Is he educated to a great extent? Can he win in quiz competition? Is he a shining student? These kinds of expectations will be there. The one who may not shine in a normal school may shine in Patashala. It's very interesting. Because a cognition which is required for Patashala is something different from a cognition which is required for a school. Modern school. This cognition is different. Here, more than one's own strong intelligence, one's own pratibha, more than all those things, what required is sraddha. I don't know how to translate this word sraddha. Sincerity is a closer translation. Sincerity, sraddha. Through Shraddha only Veda Vidya can be got. Through Shraddha only Vedanta can be got. Shishya should have Shraddha, and the Shraddha is Tapasya. Tapasvi. Tapasvi is the adjective here for a Shishya. Only one thing required is Shraddha. Whether he is handsome or not, whether he is intelligent or not, whether he looks decent or not, all these things are not required. Does he have Shraddha? What is Shraddha? Oh, I am blessed. Because I am getting Ramayana from my Guru. I am getting Vedas from my Guru. This feel is enough for a Guru, for a Shishya. Just with this feel, he will get the whole of Shastra, either Ramayana or Veda. He gets the whole of Shastra from Guru. That Shraddha is here called as tapas in the context of Shishya. Tapasvi, Vagvidambaram, Naradam, Paripuprachay. Who is Guru here and who is Shishya? Guru is Narada and the Shishya is Valmiki. That's how this epic starts. Very great epic which runs for 24,000 verses. This starts with Guru Shishya Lakshana. This great Shishya is submitting several questions to the great Guru Narada. Definitely Valmiki is a Jigyasu. The one who aspires knowledge. That is this Tapasvi. Okay. Tapasvi. And with this tapasya, with this qualification, he is sitting. I was talking about abhigamana, right? One has to go to see Guru. One has to go to have darshan of Guru. One has to search for Guru. Tasmat Guru. Narada comes to Valmiki in search of Valmiki. If sincerity is very intense, if Shraddha is very intense in the heart of Shishya, even while Shishya is sitting in his own place, Guru will come and knock the door. That's the greatness of this Shishya, Maharshi Valmiki. Narada Maharshi comes to see Valmiki. Valmiki prostrates before Narada with the folded hands. Valmiki is asking several questions. Konvasmin sampratam loke gunavan kascha viryavan dharmajnyascha kritajnyascha satyavakyaha dridavrataha charitrena chako yuktaha sarvabhuteshu kohitaha vidwan kaha kas samartascha kaschaika priyadarshanaha atmavan kaha jitakrodaha dyutiman konasuya kaha kasya bibhyati devasche jatarosasya sayuge yetadicham yaham srotum param kautuhalam hime maharshetvam samarthosi jnatumevam vidamnaram. Konvasmin sampratam loke gunavan. O Maharshi, who is crowned with all tall virtues, gunavan kascha viryavan, who is heroic in the world of gratitude, satyavakyaha, who is truthful, dridavrataha, who has strong principles, charitrena cha koyuktaha, who is a man of character, sarvabhuteshu kohitaha, who aspires the universal welfare, vidwan kaha, who is wise, kas samartascha, who is capable of doing dharma, kascha eka priyadarshanaha, who is lovable to all beings in the world, kascha eka priyadarshanaha, atmavan kaha, who is a realized soul, jitakrodaha, who has restrained his wrath, who has won his wrath, jitakrodaha dyutiman, who is luminous, kaha anasuya kaha, who is devoid of hatred, who is devoid of jealousy. Asuya has two meanings. Kaha anasuya kaha. These are all the words in one person, not just seeing in one person. He should be exemplary in all these virtues. Can I have a role model who is exemplary in all these virtues? Whatever virtue you talk, that will be found in our Rama, says Sri Anna, generally in Upanyasams. With closed eyes you can tell, yes, yes, that virtue is found in Rama, that's all. If somebody asks the question, does this virtue, is this virtue found in Rama? With closed eyes you can tell, yes. Then if you check the epic, that virtue will be found there. Nothing is left. All those virtues are found in Rama. Found means what? Not just found. For all those virtues, Rama is exemplary. I am not exaggerating. In fact, in several places we have demonstrated in the same nation, in the USA or in India, while talking to the children, in some Ramayana talks, I generally ask them the question, tell me some virtue, I will show you how it is in Rama. The whole 3 hours talks will be like that. One by one the children start to tell some virtue, tolerance. Then next few minutes, how tolerance is found in Rama. Then another child will wake up, raise its hand. It will say, forgiving nature. Then how this forgiving nature is found in Rama. That's how all those virtues, all those cannot tell that with this it gets concluded. Bhava jalanidhi sima pakshi rajena drishtaha lavana jaladi sima dashamukha bala sima raghavena api drishtaha raghupati guna sima naiva kena api drishtaha. Janaki Vijayam, this is Sri Anna's shloka. Bhava jalanidhi sima. Samsara Samudra is there, which is described as endless and beginningless. It's true. But even its boundary is found, after all, by a vulture. Jatayu got liberation with the blessings of Rama. If its boundary can be found, then what about the salty ocean? Lavana jaladi sima abhi. Hanuman crossed this Indian Ocean also and found the end. And now he has crossed from India to all these oceans. He has crossed. Lavana jaladi sima abhi anjane yena drishtaha yaya. There is another ocean. What is that? Ravana himself is an ocean. His mind is an ocean. Its boundary also is found. Ravana ocean also has its limits. Who found its boundary? Raghupati. Dasamukha bala sima raghavena api. Ramachandra found the boundary of the might ocean of Rama, the Ravana. But there is this ocean, Raghupati guna sima, the ocean of Rama gunas. Rama is a repository of these gunas. Nobody up to our time found the end of these gunas. A very great kavi, the playwright, the author of Prasanna Ragam, his name also is Jayadeva. He is asking this question in the beginning of his drama, Katham. All poets are again and again describing only Rama. They take Ramayana as their subject matter while they are writing plays. There he gives the answer. Without him, where can we take our shelter for these Nayaka's virtues? That's a wonderful answer. There he says, virtues are jealous of each other. Virtues, they can't be in a wonderful home in which all these virtues there, might may not be there. Viryam is there, humbleness, humility will not be there. If humility is there, intelligence may not be there. This is how all these virtues, they cannot stay together. With Bhimasena we can see might. With Yudhishthira we can see tolerance. That's why it is. But a capable leader has all these virtues together. Ramachandra is the shelter of all these virtues. In that way, he is great, and we see that reconciliation of all these virtues in him. We enjoy that reconciliation. We enjoy that samanvaya, that synthesis of all these virtues in him. That's what Jayadeva says. On hearing the words of Maharishi Valmiki, Valmiki then says, all these virtues should be seen in one person. Please tell about that person to me. Point number one. Konvasmin sampratam loke gunavan. And that person also should belong to our own world. Yes, yes, such a kind of person is there. He is in Vaikuntha. He has all Ananta Kalyana gunas. Or he is in Kailasa. You should not tell like that. I know that he is in Vaikuntha. But such a kind, I have to see him. If I take a bus or train or flight, I can go and see him. Is it possible like that? I want to see a contemporary human in this world who has all these virtues. Mahasamadat trilokajnaha valmikeer narado vachaha श्रूयताम इति च आमंत्र्ये प्रकृष्टो वाक्यम अब्रवीत. On hearing this, Narada Maharshi is highly motivated. It's because Narada felt, I came to talk only about it. Maharshi Valmiki is also asking about the same thing. What a wonderful thing. This is called as Sahrudaya. Sahrudaya. Unexpectedly, three or four great sadhus, they come together in a house. A sadhu came and he is sitting there. He said, I was walking by this way. I saw our house is here. Therefore, let me come here to see this guy. With this thought I came. This householder is seeing another sadhu also has come. They all have the same path. It's not that one is in Raghavasadam today. They are asking as if this accidentally came and started their satsanga, and satsangam here is atmartham. I don't know who, their own delight, their own internal hrudayam. Akhyati hrudayam hrudha. Heart talks with heart. Narada's heart, the heart is completely attuned to the heart of Valmiki. Valmiki's heart. Durlabhaschaiva yetvaya kirtitaha gunaha. Mune vakshyamyaham buddhva tair yuktaha shuyatam naraha. Bahavo durlabhaschaiva yetvaya. O Maharshe, hey Valmiki, all these gunas, is not easy to find a single person who has all these gunas. He is well known in the world, is he not? You could have known about him. Ikshvaku vamsha prabhavaha Ramo nama janishrutaha Niyatatma, his name is Rama. Even the very word Rama is sweet. Ramo nama janishrutaha Niyatatma, he is highly disciplined. Mahavirya, he is bad. Dhritiman vashi, he has restrained his senses. Buddhiman, Nitiman, Vagmi, Sriman, Shatru Nibarhanaha, Vipuram Saha, Mahabahu, Kambugrivaha, Mahahanu. Buddhiman, he is extremely intelligent. He is a man of justice. Nitiman, he is eloquent. Vagmi, I'm just translating, not even giving explanations. Shimana, he is auspicious. Shatru Nibarhanaha, he is a destroyer of the foes. Vipulam Saha Mahabahu, he has broad shoulders and arms. Shimana Vipulam Saha Mahabahu Kambugrivaha, his neck is conch shaped. Beautiful expression. Conch has three lines, right? Three marks. Rekha. So, Ramachandra has three marks in his conch-shaped neck. Kambugrivaha Mahahanu. Mahauraskaha, he has a broad chest. Mahorasko Maheshrasaha Guda Jatruhu Arindamaha Ajanubahu Susidaha Sulalataha Suvikramaha Mahoraskaha Maheshwasa. He is a very great archer, the best archer in the world. Ramaha Sastravrutamaham Maheshwasahaya Guda Jatruhu, his collarbones are not visible. Arindamaha Ajanubahu, his long hands are resplendent. Sushirahaya, his round head, which has that Raja Tilaka, shines. So Vikramaha. Vikramaha commentary runs in this way. Kamu Pada Vikshepe, that's the dhatu of it. Therefore, so Vikramaha means one who walks like an elephant in rut. So Vikramaha gaga. Samaha, Samavibhaktangaha gaga. Snigdha Varnaha, Pratapavan. Peanut. लक्षाः विशालाक्षः लक्ष्मीवान् शुभलक्षणः समः. हि मेंटेन्स इक्विपोइस, हि मेंटेन्स इक्विलिब्रियम. समः देन समविभक्तांगः, ऑल हिज लिम्स आर वेल प्रोपोर्शनेट, वेल डिवाइडेड. हिज बॉडी रिफ्लेक्ट्स हिज लाइफस्टाइल. टू वर्ड्स आर देयर हियर, समः समविभक्तांगः. His limbs are well proportioned. Why his limbs are well proportioned? Because he has a life of equipoise. That's a very interesting thing. Vihara viharasya in food, then yukta swapna avabodhasya in waking and sleep, yukta cheshtasya in deeds. If he maintain moderation everywhere, niha, in Tamil we call it as niha. If you maintain moderation everywhere, then by that yoga becomes effective. Yogeshwara says, Bhagavan Sri Krishna says, here Sri Ramachandra, as he maintains moderation everywhere in his life, he is called as samaha. Therefore his body reflects it, all his limbs are in moderation. Ramachandra is snigdhavarna. What is snigdha? Snigdhavarna has several meanings. Snigdha, one means attractive. Rama has an attractive color. Rama's color captivates the heart of his devotees. Snigdhavarna. Rama is dark in complexion. Varnam shyamam samashritah. That's how Sundarakandam says. And he is like a cloud. Megha shyamam mahabhagam sthirasattvam jitendriyam. Here, without mentioning his color, just Valmiki says, sorry, Narada says, snigdha varna. Snigdha, attractive color. Rama has attractive color. This is one meaning. Another meaning, snigdha means wet iram, and either it wets our heart or his skin has a glow, his skin has a luster which has iram in itself. Okay, that is snigdha varna. It's another meaning. And in our tradition, we describe Rama in green color also. Rama is green in color. That's why green tulasi is called as Rama tulasi, and this dark tulasi is called as Krishna tulasi. Green in color. How he is green? Valmiki describes him only as dark, shyamala varna. Why he is green? Yeah, it is possible. Ranganatha Moolavar is dark in color. But Alvar says, Pachaima Malai Bol Medi. Green. Yes, Raghunatha is like, Raghunatha resembles a green mountain. We see many green mountains everywhere in this country. You see everywhere grass. Green grass. Bhagavan Narayana is like that. How? It's because our mind, our heart becomes calm on seeing the green. The same calmness, the same joy, the same delight, the same expansion of mind we experience on seeing Bhagavan's varna, Bhagavan's color. Therefore, it can be called as green. Snigdha varnahaya prathapavanege peenavakshaha. He has a mighty chest, vishalakshaha, round shoulders and eyes. Lakshmivan shubalakshanaha. He has all best physical features, subalakshanaha. After describing his physique in this way, Narada continues. Then he says, dhata ripunishudanaha rakshita jita. Then dharana dhyana comes in vashyaha, including pratyahara, then samadhi ma. All these eight limbed yoga, those are effortlessly found in he guards the whole world, care of the whole world, how he takes, how he is gracing the whole world by all these things, by through sunlight. He offered sunlight, make him to be Godhead. He offers sunlight, he offers proper raining, and he offers proper seasons like winter and all, summer and all. He also has offered us this healthy body, healthy mind. All these things are grace of the divine. Rakshana's feet, by giving a place to see Mahatmanaha in this way, he is guarding us. This is the meaning of Chakara. So Janasya Cha Rakshita. Also, he is guarding us also. He is guarding his own people too. What is this too? By taking care of his own people, by giving a place in the shadow of his lotus feet. Swajanasya cha rakshita ga ga rakshita sosye dharmasye. He is for everybody. He is common to all, and he is special to his devotees. Then he guards dharma. He guards dharma in general. He guards his own dharma too. These are wonderful expressions. What is dharma in general? Yes, universal welfare. Loka samasta sukhino bhavantu is dharma in general. In the same way, he guards his own dharma. What is that? Sharanagata samrakshana. Swajanasya cha rakshita, rakshita jivalokasya. Then next shloka, veda vedanga tattvajnaha dharurvede cha nishthitaha sarvashastrartha tattvajnaha smritivan pratibhanavan veda vedanga tattvajnaha. Vedas, but also vedangas. One may be expert in one veda, but he knows all the vedas. And then shiksha, kalpa, vyakarana, nirupta, chandas and jyotisha, these are the vedangas. Rama is expert in all these vedangas. Veda vedanga tattvajnaha. Then he knows dhanurveda also. Dhanurveda is his own veda. Being a kshatriya, he has learned dhanurveda. He is expert in missiles. Dhanurvede cha nishtitaha. Anything is left here to cover that also. Sarva shastrartha tattvajnaha. Rama knows all shastras. Valmiki gives an expression here. Rama knows all shastras. Whatever is left here, probably Upavedas like Ayurveda, Gandharva, Shilpa Shastra, all those shastras also he knows. Sarva Shastra, he not only knows these shastras in a verbal way, but also knows the meaning of those shastras. That's a very interesting thing. One can chant the verses found in Shastra. One can recite them. One can mug up them. But on the other hand, learning with meaning becomes more significant. This is how Yaska says. Therefore, here, Sarva Shastra Artha. Rama knows the Shastra. Rama knows the meaning of the Shastra. Not only meaning, there is something more than the meaning. Artha Tattvajnaha. Valmiki calls it as Tattva. Later literary critics call it as Dhvani. Dhvanyaloka. We have a very great literary criticism called Dhvanyaloka. Dhvani. Dhvani. Understanding the Dhvani of literature. Later this was taken by English literarians also. As tone. Long, long ago, people thought that a kavya becomes an ideal kavya only by its figures of speech. But later, some great seers found kavya is not ideal because of just figures of speech, but by this dhvani or tone. Valmiki calls it as tattva, sarva shastra artha. Sarva shastra artha tattvajnaha. Rama. Sarva Shastrartha Tattvajnaha. How he knows all these things? How he came to know all these things? It's not just because of his memory power. Smritiman, he is a deep thinker. Next statement, next description. He is a deep thinker. He thinks a lot. He contemplates a lot. Smritiman. Smriti has two meanings. One memory, another one thinking. What kind of thinking it is? Shastri thinking. Shastram vichintitam api pravichintaniyam. Taking a statement from Shastra and thinking about it and then deriving something out of it. Next. Deriving something out of it and questioning it. From that question an answer is derived. From that answer another question is derived. From that question another answer is derived. This is called as Pratibha. Pratibha, intuition. Smritiman, he is a thinker as well as he is intuitive. Those who think may not be intuitive. Those who are intuitive may not be thinkers. But Ramachandra is a thinker as well as a man of intuition. Therefore, Smritiman, Pratibhanavan. That's the greatness of Rama. Through his intuition, through his contemplation, through his thought, he grasped all Shastras, what he learnt from Maharishi Vasishtha. Sarva Shastrartha Tatvajnaha Smritiman Pratibhanavan Sarva Loka Priyaha Sadhu Adinatma Vichakshanahaya Sarvada Abhigata Sadbihi Samutraiva Sindubihi Sarva Loka Priyaha. Ramachandra is lovable to all people, all beings in the world. That's how we see in Ramakatha. Sarva Loka Priyaha among the authors of Ramayana. There are various Ramayanas in the world. Ramayana has transcended the boundary of languages. In Hindi we have Ramayana, in Odia we have Ramayana. In Bengali we have Ramayana, in Tamil we have Ramayana. It transcended all the languages. It crossed the boundaries of caste. For example, different caste people wrote Ramayanas. For example, Tulsidas or Sant Ekanath is a Brahmin who wrote Ramayana. On the other hand, Kamban is a weaver. Eluthachan is a fisherman. Different kinds of people belonging to different castes, they wrote Ramakathas in the world. Not only this, different religions, the saints belonging to different religions extol Ramachandra. We have Jain Ramayana, we have Bauddha Ramayana, we also have Sikh Ramayana. Bauddha Ramayana is there, it's called as Dasaratha Jatakam. Jain Ramayana is Paumacharya. Sikh Ramayana is Ramavatara Charita, written by Guru Govind Singh. A very famous literature in Punjab. In this way, it also crosses the religions. And in fact, Ramayana is found, it crosses the seas, it crosses the countries. Thailand Ramayana, Indonesia Ramayana, and then you can see Ramayana in Sri Lanka. You can see Ramayana in various countries like Cambodia. This is how Ramayana we find everywhere. Sarvaloka Priyaha. Rama is lovable to all beings in the world. Sarvaloka Priyaha. Why? Because Sadhu who is Sadhu. I don't know how to translate this up. Good. Good. It's not just nowadays we use the word sadhu if somebody doesn't have any capability. Paam sadhu. Not such kind. If somebody is getting cheated always, then we say sadhu. Not that kind of sadhu. But what kind of sadhu he is? Adhinatma. Sarvaloka Priyaha Sadhu Adhinatma. Adhinatma means he is grand as well as sadhu. Sarvaloka Priyaha Sadhu Adhinatma Vichakshanahaya. He is grand like an ocean. many rivers come to the ocean. The ocean is not bothering, oh, all these rivers are coming, how I am going to bear all these things, all these rivers. Many, much more water will come, then there will be a huge flood. Such kind of worry doesn't come to the ocean. Ocean is happy. The ocean is always inviting all the rivers by its waves. Sarvada abhigata sadbihi samudraiva sindhubihi. Like all rivers are rushing towards this ocean. See, some gravity is pulling all these rivers to the ocean, I think. See how much distance ocean and rivers have. You take Ganga. Ganga is coming out of Gangotri in Himalayas. And where it joins, somewhere in Sagar Sangam, Ganga Sagar Sangama, it's called as. In between, some 700 kilometers, I don't know. More than that. But you see, how this Ganga in nature, nobody dragged Ganga to get joined with this ocean. Nowadays, they are talking about river linking project. And nobody was doing that on those days. For Ganga, Bhagiratha, they did fine. For all other rivers, for Godavari, for Kaveri is starting from Karnataka somewhere. But it merges the rivers, river searches, and finally crossing so many regions, finally it comes to this great ocean. Like Hasina is coming from Iran to see Lord Krishna in Vrindavan. You know the story, Hasina Hamida story in Vaishnava Samhita. The same way, such hundreds of kilometers it crosses and comes to the ocean, merges with ocean. Sadhus, in the same way they rush to Bhagavan Ramachandra. They merge with Bhagavan Ramachandra, yatha nadyaha, siddhamanaha, samudre, astam gacchanti, namarupe vihaya. Like the rivers merge in the ocean, the same way all our thoughts, all our senses, they merge in the Surupa, in Atman, Upanishad tells us. The same way sadhus are merging, they see their aikyata, they see their oneness with Ramachandra. Hanuman, he was born somewhere nearby Kishkinda, but he saw Ramachandra and he merged in Ramachandra. That's a Vibhishana, somewhere in Lanka he was born, he surrendered himself to Rama, he also merged in Ramachandra. Samudraiva Sindhubihi. Aryaha sarva samaschaive sadaika priyadarsanaha. Sacha sarva guno betaha kausalya anandavartanaha. The word Arya generally means a gentleman, a noble person. And the word used in many places, the Vedic literature generally, is to show a Vedic man, the one who practices, one who is cultured with the Vedic rituals. He is called as Arya. Sarva Samaha means one who maintains equality. His dharma is equality. He neither compromises his Aryatva for Sarva Samatva, nor compromises Sarva Samatva for Aryatva. It means he neither compromises his Vedic rituals for his nature of equality, nor compromises his nature of equality for his Vedic rituals. Or yaha sarva samaschaive ye adhi samatva bandhu sahite ye dujeva vyadeva swajana rachite kathayeva. Ramachandra is happy both in forest and in kingdom. Perhaps he is happier in. That's why Vaneva comes from his own kingdom. Vaneva Rajyevaya. Rajya, kingdom was filled with his own subjects, Ayodhyans. On the other hand, the forest was filled with Khaga Mruga Yute, birds and the animals, he enjoyed it more. Sukheva, dukheva, joy or misery, he maintained equanimity. Swajana rachide durjana krite, joy offered by his own people, durjana krite, misery offered by those who did not wish the welfare of Ramachandra, both he took in a equal way. Neither he developed a hatred towards those who created misery to him. Swachana rachite durjana krite. And then sukheva dukheva paneva rajyeva kakamrugayute bandhu sahite dujeva vyadeva. He sees Maharshi Vasishta, very great Brahmarshi, with the same eye of love he sees this hunter Nishadaraj Guha also. That's the greatness of Ramachandra. Aryaha sarva samaschaivege sadaika priyadarshanaha. Priyadarshanaha, if somebody sees him, he gives his heart. Okay. Sadaika priyadarshanaha. Priyadarshanaha means lovable. Eka priyadarshanaha ga, if somebody sees him, then he alone is chosen in his heart. If somebody sees him, he submits his heart and heart is not coming back. That is Eka Priyadarshana. When heart is not coming back, when he is in proximity. If he is in proximity, then my heart cannot be withdrawn from him. It's not like that. Even after his crossing of that place, Atikrante Viragave, Sada Eka Priyadarshana. Always he is like that. After seeing him, my heart is pleasant. My heart goes to ecstasy only when, only in the remembrance of him. I always think on him. Why? It's because I am unable to withdraw my heart from him. Sadaika priyadarshana haya. All these gunas he has. Such a sarva gunopetahaya. After telling this, Narada says, Kausalyanandavardhanaha. He doesn't tell about anybody here. Dasaratananda Vardhana he could have told. Athava or Vishwamitrananda Vardhanaha, Janakyananda Vardhanaha, Hanumadananda Vardhanaha, Sugrivananda Vardhanaha, Vibhishanananda Vardhanaha. But in these virtues he talks only about Kausalya. He takes the epithet of Kausalya. He takes the name of Kausalya. Kausalyananda Vardhanaha. It's because mother becomes extremely happy if the son is highly virtuous. Umachi nalla buddhi kudu, Sri Anna says. And the mother takes to Bhagavan, this child. Mother doesn't pray, Umachi, you pray. My dear child, you pray, Umachi, I should become an IAS collector. What she teaches, nalla buddhi kudu. Bless this child with a good thought. So on seeing this boy growing in a virtuous way, mother becomes happy. Kausalyananda Vardhanaha, Rama grows the bliss of Kausalya. Kausalyananda Vardhanaha. Samudraiva gambhirye dhairyena himavanive Vishnuna sadruso virye somavat priyadarshanaha. Rama is grand. Rama is unfathomable. Rama is fathomless like ocean. Samudraiva gambhiryeye. When we go to the sea, we may become awestruck, wonderstruck, just by seeing the peripheral layer of the sea. The same way, only the peripheral layer of Ramachandra is visible, even for that we become dumbstruck. Samudraiva gambhiryeye. There are rare people who fathom that sea, to find out the pearls, diamonds found in that sea. The same way there are people, there are devotees who fathom Ramachandra, who go into the depth of Ramachandra to collect those pearls of gunas. Samudraiva gambhirye. Samudra not only has pearls but also salt. But Ramachandra doesn't have salt at all. Therefore he exults the ocean in his grandeur. Samudraiva gambhirye dhairyena himavanive. Dhairya has two meanings, one to be courageous, another one to be stable. Here this Dhairyam is Thairyam only. Rama is stable like mountain Himalayas. Sthiraha swadharme himavan ivachalaha. Even by the very great cyclone, Himalaya doesn't get affected. Himalayas is not shaken. The same way, even if a blow of temptations comes, those things cannot do anything. Rama is stubborn in his dharma. Dhairyena himavani vegeye, Vishnuna sadruso virye. He is as heroic as Mahavishnu. Why he should be compared with Mahavishnu? He is Mahavishnu, right? Therefore, the commentator says, this is not Upamalankara, but Samanvayalankara. This has to be taken as Gaganam Gaganakara. Space is like space. Okay, in the same way, Rama is like Mahavishnu, means Rama like Rama is like Rama. Mahavishnu na sadruso virye, sohamavat priyadru samahagaga. Rama is lovable like the moon. Okay, moon is loved by all except thieves, because it is showing light. People will find the thieves in the light. The same way, those who have hatred to Rama are thieves. So bhavatu priyadarshanaha. There are few things in the world are subjective. For example, if you see some building, this building is very beautiful, one may tell, one may say. Another one may not say, no, I don't like this building. If somebody is having a cup of tea, he may say, a coffee, wonderful. Another one may say, nothing is there in coffee. Okay. So it's subjective. Beauty lies in the eye. But if you see in nature, moon's beauty is subjective. No, everybody loves it. Everybody loves moon. The same way Ramachandra is as lovable as moon. It means Rama's beauty is not subjective. Anybody who sees Ramachandra has to give his heart. Somavatu priyadarshanaha. Even moon has a kalanka in it. Moon has some black color in between, some mark in it, but Ramachandra's face is serene and it is always resplendent. Somavatu priyadarshanaha kalagni sadrusaha krode kshamaya prithivi samaha. Ramachandra is kshamaya prithivi samaha. He is extremely tolerant like Mother Earth. On the other hand, when adharma cannot be controlled without the rage of Rama, when his rage becomes relevant, sthana krodaha praharta cha, then his rage comes out of his heart like an volcanic eruption. That is this kalagni sadrusa. Kalagni means volcanic eruption. Kalagni is lava. Rama's rage is like lava. Kalagni sadrusa krode kshamaya prithivi samaha. And he is like dharma devata in his truthfulness. Satya dharma ivapara. After describing all these qualities, virtues of Ramachandra, Narada Maharshi tells the whole story of Rama in nutshell, which is called as Sankshepa Ramayana, the first chapter of Ramayana. Today we have enjoyed this first chapter of Ramayana. Tomorrow we shall continue. Janaki kam tasmaranam.